Hit the red subscribe button and press the bell icon to never miss another update from Techetarian. Hello friends, this is Harsh Trivedi from Techetarian, and today I'll be showing you how to create a bootable Kali Linux Pendrive. So for that, you will need a Kali Linux ISO image, universal USB installer, and obviously a pendrive. Visit kali.org/downloads to download the ISO image and opt between 64-bit, 32-bit, 64-bit light or 32-bit light ISO images. Now, if your internet connection is fast enough, directly click on the ISO link. And if it is not like that of mine, use the torrent link, because many times it happens that the download just stops for no reason and you cannot do anything except of downloading it again. So torrent becomes a helping hand in this kind of a situation. Now if the download interrupts for no reason, torrent will try to resume it from the part where it was interrupted. Now to download Universal USB Installer, head over to pendrivelinux.com. Find a link to Universal USB Installer and directly click on the Download UUI button. Just to save some time, I already have downloaded both of the required files, so I'll quickly plug my pendrive to the system. And as you can see, it is a 16GB USB, out of which I get 14.5GB free. So let's begin with the process by starting up Universal USB Installer just by double click on the exe file and click on yes to give all the permissions needed by the software. Now click on I agree to skip terms and conditions, and now click on the drop down menu under step 1 and choose Kali Linux under security and penetration testing label. Now click on the browse button and locate the downloaded Kali Linux ISO file, and let me tell you one most important thing about this software, that if there are multiple Linux ISOs available in the folder which contains the required file, it will automatically hide all of the ISOs and show up all the ISOs of the pre-selected distributions. Like, I have selected Kali Linux in the drop down menu, so it will only show ISO images of Kali Linux and hide ISO images of all of the distributions. Now under step 3, click on the drop down menu and select your storage device and recheck the drive letter, because if you select any of your hard drive partitions, you may get into some real trouble. Now that you have placed everything in place, click on the create button and click on yes. And after that, sit back, relax and enjoy. Till then, let me tell you one more interesting thing about Universal USB Installer, that it comes packed up with 7-zip. So either you have 7-zip on your system or not, this software doesn't care. This just works smoothly without letting the user to face the real hassle. So now when the extraction has been completed successfully, click on the close button and recheck your storage device, that if it has been filled up with Kali Linux system files or not. And now simply restart your system and open your boot manager by clicking on your system's boot key. It may vary from system to system. Now boot your system from your storage device and choose Live Boot option from the Kali Linux Live Boot menu to quickly boot from your bootable Kali Linux pendrive. Now wait for Kali Linux to boot from your bootable USB. And as you can see, you have successfully created a bootable Kali Linux pendrive. So that's it for this video. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe, and leave your queries in the comment section below.